Hi guys, I'm out again. This time something just a little bit different. Those of you that watch my channel know that I'm into the outdoor stuff, wild camping, fishing and that sort of thing. Also have other hobbies which I don't really normally share with you. One of them is metal detecting. But first I'll just like to thank Paul for inviting us along to his new permission. You know, he's only had it a couple of weeks and it's looking promising. And really this video is all about me trying out, you know, filming metal detecting, because I've never been able to do that in the past because of not having, you know, a permission myself. It's a little bit difficult for me to try and branch out and bring new things to the channel. So it's really, you know, it's asking you guys for help, you subscribers. If any of you have any land and you wouldn't mind me and my friend coming on and doing a bit of metal detecting, we've got the liability insurance, National Council of Metal Detecting, which covers you for loss of life and damage to property and that sort of thing. But it's just proves that, you know, if you've got that insurance, that you're responsible. And those of you that watch my channel know that when I'm out in the wilderness, I leave no trace, I don't make a mess, I take all my rubbish away, and we're not likely to be digging holes and just leaving. You guys that have got land, you may be interested to see what's actually underneath your feet. You know, there's a lot of history out there, and there's always the chance of that spectacular find of treasure. And I'm not sure what the treasure trove laws are these days, but usually the landowner and the finder gets 50-50 or something like that, depending on how you would like to do that.
We're nearly here.
Get out and do a bit of wild camping. No, it makes sense.
That's wild camping, man.
I'm just that used to saying that. Get up and do a bit of metal detecting. You know what makes sense?
Detecting. One, two, three.
Get out and do a bit of detecting. You know what makes sense. You know what makes sense. Six inches down. It's really thin.
That looks like a ship.
It's dead thin though, isn't it?
Aye. It's got the ship and it's got half written up there. Foo-foo spray. So that's George.
Right guys, we'll keep looking. Catch us in a bit.
Got a little round in the hole.
A little round. Something round. There it is. See that? Oh,
it's what you call a threatens.
Oh, you can see the straight edges.
Old threepence.
Still a bit of history. It's a bit toasted.
It's a bit toasted, aye.
But it's nice to find something anyway.
Oh, absolutely.
I think it's an old penny.
Oh, two.
Ah, just the one. That's the imprint.
Oh, the imprint. I'm looking for the viewfinder here. Oh, that's nice, that. Big old penny.
George V, probably. George. Just see it. Tanya on the back, but needs further cleaning.
At least that's coins here, that's the main thing.
Another live reveal. It's in the clod.
Ooh.
That, it's a button.
Button. Looks like a coin or
maybe gold gilded at one point. Or silver. There.
Oh yeah.
Who knows? It's a bit too far gone, like, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, you're getting imp now. Well, you've done better than me.
Well, that one's yours, isn't it?
Is it?
That one's a modern halfpenny, that one.
Is it? So, I mean, I've only found the one coin. So, obviously, I'm faffing on with the filming and all that. But it's still nice to see, you know, that stuff here. And, I've actually got a target here. It's coming in at a 13. So, I'm going to give this one a dig.
Little bit of lead, copper.
I don't know.
Got the green.
Little bit of copper, thin, quite thin. Lightweight, it's a bit of scrap.
leave no trace.
I leave no trace. You know, when doing a detecting, you know it makes sense. You know it makes sense. What we got? Oh, half penny perhaps?
It's
old.
It's gone. Too much.
Yes, it's bringing up some finds, this field.
Yeah, yeah.
I've got a 12 signal here in this hole. I'm just about to find out what it is. A bit of metal.
That's looks like a razor blade, that.
It is. That's modern, that. Oh well, not very exciting, that, is it? Compared to your coin.
Medieval bit.
There are two different types of people in this world, my friend. Those who dig and those with cameras. You dig.
It's deep down that, that's gonna be.
Try it on the 10 kilohertz.
It's jumping out of the place, that's deep iron.
It's not worth the hassle, is it?
Nah.
The Equinox has got a habit of picking up iron, especially deep iron, or certain ringed iron, but you know, iron can fool any detector. But the fact is, it's a deep target, the signal's jumping all over, it's in the negatives. So, chances are it's iron, it's just not worth digging, basically. A reading of 9 and 10 had to be dug because hammer's coming at that sort of range. Never mind, on to the next one. Don't know how well you can see that, that's a solid 16 all the way around, about 6 inches deep. I'm gonna have to dig this one, it's just too tempting. I'll show you how it's done.
I got the same signal,
16. Alright, sweet 16. I've got a sweet 16. Oh, a bit of metal, thin. Copper metal. Better look on the next one. 22. 4 inches down.
What we got? A bit of jewellery.
Like aluminium that's melted.
Yeah.
Maybe it's a crushed Messerschmitt or something like that. Or Spitfire.
Aye.
Engine part or something. Never mind. Oh well. Better look next time. Get out and do a bit of metal detecting. You know, it makes sense. Just took a target, came up 15. Maybe a button, maybe a coin, I don't know what it is yet. Let's take a look. Could be a coin. Actually looks like it's blooming glittering with blooming. What do you reckon this is, Paul?
It's definitely a button. I've got a load of these gilded in the middle. The shank's just been that fine. It's just compressed and it's rotted into it.
It's been like welded on or like soldered on or something back in the day.
But that's real gold there.
Is it? Well, it's still better than a ring pull. Right, onto the next one.
What's that coming on at?
15. And there's Paul there with his fantastic new machine. You bought one because I had one.
Copy them, mate.
The Nox, right, it's finding stuff where other machines have gone before. It sounds like an episode of Star Trek, doesn't it? to boldly go where no machine has gone before. Or has gone before, I should say, and oh, found someone, have you?
Four roller button.
Oh well. This corner seems to have a lot more activity. You normally find that in the corner of fields. You often find a lot of stuff just dumped there as well, trash. Yeah. Right, on to the next one. Hopefully it's a coin and a hammy.
Coming up 27, 28. About 4 inches down.
Ah, that's good. Solid signal all the way around.
That's what we want.
This is what we're looking for. It helps if I turn the spear gun around.
Oh,
Elizabeth. Modern 2 pence. Oh well. That's one for the collection.
Doing the waggle dance.
We're going to get back to the car. We're going to like spread all the finds out and see exactly what we've got. Do a bit of a roundup.
Got a few half pennies, 2 pence, a threepence, a couple of full pennies, modern day half penny. That's maybe a modern day 5 pence as well, I'm not sure. A couple of buttons.
Yeah. And the rest of the stuff is just like junk, basically.
Got a load of lead there at the top. Found this interesting handle of an old ceramic beaker or something.
That's right. It's like a metal handle, but it's also, it's gone through the ceramic, hasn't it?
Yeah.
That's a bit that's cracked off. Left some of the ceramic, like a pin has gone through. Aye. And this thing as well, it's off a poker or a bedpost, perhaps.
That's another buckle.
Yeah.
Remnants of a buckle.
Yeah. Because you've got the rough bit there, which would have gripped onto the leather. That could be old, that.
Come out the same hole as what I got that.
Yeah. Another buckle there. So basically some modern stuff, some old stuff, medieval bic, perhaps. It's plastic, that, so it can't be. So really, a bit of a mixed bag.
It's been a canny day.
We'll get away and we'll catch us all in the next one. Get out and do some metal detecting, you know, it makes sense. Or kayaking, or fishing, or whatever. Wild
anything
camping.
Outside.